Centennial celebration, we are talking with Sierra County citizens that have lived here for many years. Today, we're talking with Maxine Cecil. She is a longtime resident, business owner, and fisherwoman. Thank you, Maxine, for allowing us to look at your life and be here with you today. We'll have several questions to ask, and if you don't know the answer, just say, I don't know.
Fishing all of the time, baby going fishing too. That's your life, your sweet wife will catch more fish than you. Many fish bites if you got good bait. Here's a little tip that I would like to relate. Many fish bites if you got good bait. I'm a going fishing, yes, I'm going fishing, and my baby going fishing too. I went on down to my favorite fishing hole. Baby grabbed me a pole and a line. Threw my pole on and caught a 9-pound catfish. Now you know I brought him home for supper time. Proving any fish bites if you got good bait. Here's a little tip that I would like to relate. Many fish bites if you got good bait. I'm a going fishing, yes I'm going fishing. And my baby going fishing too. Baby brother about to run me out of my mind. Say, can I go fishing with you? I took him on down to the fishing hole. Now, what do you think that he did do? Pull a great big fish out the bottom of the pond. Now, he laughed and jumped because he was real gone. Many fish bites if you got good bait. I'm a-going fishing, yes, I'm going fishing. And my baby going fishing too. Put him in the pot, baby, put him in the pan. Honey, cook him till he's nice and brown. Make a batch of buttermilk, whole cakes, mama, and chew them things and then jump them on down. Singing any fish bites if you got good bait. Here's a little tip that I would like to relate. Many fish bites if you got good bait. I'm a going fishing, yes, I'm going fishing. And my baby going fishing to play the blues.
I was born October the 27th of 1920.
So that makes you how old?
I'm 90.
90 years old. Who are your parents?
James T. and Barbara Louise Lane.
Okay, where were they from?
My dad, James Thomas Wayne, was born there in Kansas. And I think my mother was born in Illinois. I do not know.
When did they come to Hot Springs?
She never did come. She died. She died she was 37.
Oh, so it was your father that came?
My dad came down because he was kind of puny. And he just come down here about 3 months out of the year and messed around here and laid around, and he was always sickly.
You took the baths?
No.
Just because of the climate?
He never took baths.
So when did you come?
I came down here in 1947.
And why did you come? To see about him?
Mm-hmm.
And when you got here, what did you do?
When I first got here?
Yeah.
So you mean from Kansas?
Yes.
I don't know. I had a little motel when I was busy.
And where was your little motel?
Right there where Sherry and Baxter is now.
On Broadway.
I had 11 units.
And it was called what? What was the name of it?
Broadway Courts.
It was right across the street from where Alco is now, right?
Well, not just right across. That was Guy Martin's place right across.
And then
I was across from Army Armstrong's gas station.
And then what businesses have been where Alco is now? What were some of the businesses?
I really don't know.
There was
unless it was that hotel and restaurant. I don't know. Freddie Torres can tell you about that.
Well, there was a, first I think they had kind of a hospital or something there, and then they had a restaurant and a bar and a dance hall and all kinds of things down through the years.
When did you come here?
In 1939.
Then you ought to know all these questions.
Yeah, well, I'm asking you. Because I don't remember that, because I was born here, so. Back then I can't remember some of the things that were here. Okay, tell about, why did people come and stay in your court? What was here that made people come and stay?
Taking baths and just like you do when you go to a motel, just lay around. And
but they mainly took the baths? Mm-hmm. Did any of them that had patients in Caratingly stay there? Mm-hmm. It would have been
I had a lot of them from Gallup.
Oh, and it probably was very easy access to Caratingly from.
Well, Caratingly is right up the hill from my motel.
And then you also had, along with this motel, you had another business. What was that?
With the motel? I just had the motel and then went into the tackle business.
Okay.
But that was quite a few years
later.
Between.
Okay, tell me.
That's all I had.
The Fiesta came along in the 1950s, that they changed the name of the town. Were you for or against them changing the name of the town?
Against.
Any special reason why?
Well, Hot Springs was known all over for the Hot Springs. So I couldn't see any sense in what they did.
Do you think then it didn't help the town at all?
I really don't know.
Must not have if you, it didn't make.
As far as I'm concerned, they could change it back to Hot Springs.
That's good.
That's the way I feel about it. You ask me how I feel,
that's
I'm going to tell you.
That's great. every year they have the Fiesta, and it was a big deal. What did you particularly like about the Fiestas that you enjoyed and took part in them? What part of the Fiesta did you enjoy?
What did I enjoy about it?
Yeah.
I never watched one of them except when she was on the mule.
What was she doing on a mule?
She was in the parade.
Oh, okay.
The parade, though, used to come by the tackle shop all the time, remember? And we would sit out front and watch it because her business was right there on the parade route.
You had a prime seat. You didn't have to get up at 7 o'clock in the morning and take your car.
No, she was right there.
Just walk out the front door. Mm-hmm. Did you ever take part in the parade? Did you ever go to one of the radio shows? Mm-mm. I can't find anybody that did, yet they always had a big crowd.